Good morning. So I am just on my way to go meet Zoe. We're shooting stuff for a campaign for Gordon's Ultra Low. Might not get approved, but we do have an event with them this week, so it'd be quite surprising if it didn't. I just missed the bus, and it's another half an hour until the next one comes. Well, it's gonna come in 7 minutes, but it's been a half an hour, so frustrating. I need to start driving soon. So yeah, a little bit crabby, but let's go. So an hour and 45 minutes, we're here. That was a struggle. So basically there is a marathon going on in Bristol today, and then there's a festival, and then because of the marathon, a lot of the roads are shut. So literally it took forever. So anyways, we're just gonna set up the scene and get shooting because it's been raining as well. So here comes Miss Organized herself. How cute and autumnal does she look? Welcome back to the vlog. All right, this was the setup for my situation. Cute. I had the master flat lay. Master flat layist. Flat layer. And yeah, now we're gonna set up for her situation. All right, check out this setup now. Yeah. So cute. You know what? It's actually because it ties in with the blue from that. Just check it out. Hello. So I'm vlogging today because I'm about to go for a hair consultation at the salon. Basically, I'm just going in for a patch test to see if I have any allergies. But I don't think I'm going to show you the whole experience in this video. But I'll show you little bits and pieces. And then I'm gonna go home and have an easy night because this week is gonna be so crazy, but it means a lot of cool stuff to vlog, so let's go. And this is where I'm going, here at 58. So long, my heart's been far from you, 10,000 miles gone. Oh, I wanna come near it. Every part of me, but there's blood on my hands, and my lips are unclear. In my darkness, I remember Mama's words reoccur to me. Surrender to the good Lord, and He'll wipe your slate clean.
Yeah, totally. I don't think, like, normally if I do color it, it's like I stay with that color for like 2 years. because it's just, it's so fine that it breaks so easy. It's not worth it. So I just finished my light color. We've got like 2 years of it being dark.
Alright, so I'm back at home and I'm shooting content. Now this is what I was shooting with Zoe yesterday, but when I went to go edit the pictures last night, I noticed that the label of the bottle wasn't really in focus, so the brand hasn't got back to me yet, but I figured I would just retake it and have an alternative option for them just in case. So just did that, but look at this, my tripod setup, because I broke the plate, well, I broke the screw that the plate hooks on to the big camera, and I wanted to get home and redo this instead of going to the store to go buy a new plate, so I had to make do. That it was quite ridiculous, but anyways, I thought I would just quickly tell you guys, because I'm probably gonna just end this vlog part section here, but I thought I would tell you what I've got going on this week. So tomorrow is my only free day, and I'm just gonna come home and try and go to bed, because I'm really stressed out. So these videos would not be live on my channel anymore, on my vlog channel. They're there, but I've got them on private. But basically, when I'm stressed out, I get the worst canker sores. Here in England, you call them ulcers. My mouth is freaking, like, there's so many of them in there. I've been so stressed out with my house in Canada, with the dogs, but I finally think it's starting to wind down. The dogs should get here on Thursday. They should be here Thursday around 4. So tomorrow's my only free day. Wednesday I have an event for that Gordon's barely, it's like barely gin. It's like 0.5% gin. But I've got an event for that at this place called Slug and Lettuce. And then Thursday, there's a benefit event, like a benefit cosmetics. So the dogs are due to get here at like 4. I finish work at like 4. So I'm not going to take lunch that day. I'm going to come home a bit early. I highly doubt they'll be here right at 4 on the dot. Nothing seems to ever go according to plan. But they're going to get here, and then I'm going to take off to that event. Then Friday morning, I get my lashes done, and then we have a funeral. Then Saturday, I have a facial, and then I think I'm going to Bath. And then that's Saturday, and then I don't know, probably hang out with Paul. Then Sunday, I have a photo shoot with Hannah in the morning, and then Paul's sister's coming over for dinner. Then Monday, I just showed you guys that I was at that hair salon. They did a patch test on me. I don't know if the hair dye is back there and you can see it. I can't see it myself. But on Monday, I go get my hair done, a trim, and just a freshen up of the color. I'm not doing anything crazy. And then Monday afternoon, I'm meeting a lady that owns an aesthetics clinic here just for coffee. And then Tuesday, I don't know, but I think that's it. But like literally, basically, tomorrow until next Tuesday, I have things planned like the whole time. So I'm off until Wednesday. So hopefully Tuesday, Wednesday, I can just chill out, but that is a lot. So I don't have time to redo this, and I've kind of got to be efficient with my time, because when you work for yourself, you kind of have to make sure that you are on top of things. And I mean, I still have a full-time job, but I need to like make sure I'm still creating content and stuff as well. So I'm getting paid from that. So it's going to be a busy one, but yeah, ramble. That's what I've got going on. That's what you're going to see in this vlog. Are you ready? Hello. So I am headed to an event at Slug and Lettuce. So basically it's with Gordon's Gin and Tonic, and it's their low alcohol gin and tonic. So let's go. Anyways, hello, how's it going? I just saw you yesterday, but you're gonna see me again today. I don't think you'll see me tomorrow, because tomorrow's not really an event day or anything fun. Although Paul does have the day off. We're going to a funeral, unfortunately. Anybody with curly hair know the struggle of like when your hair gets wet when you shower and then it's like frizzy and you don't want to re-straighten it. Anyways, exciting times. The dogs should be here any second. And of course their flight was delayed, and their flight was like something was wrong with the plane, so then they got on the later flight. If they had got on the flight that they were supposed to get on, they would have got here like right when I got home. But of course something happened, and I'm heading to an event, so I'm actually just gonna get them, let them go pee, and then get an Uber to the event. Anyways, I'm super excited to see them. I think sometimes we do overhumanize like them though, that I'm sure I'll see them and let them go out and go pee and they'll be all right. It's just a quick event, but yeah. So I tried using an Uber the other day and it wouldn't let me edit my credit card. So I'm gonna try and do that now, so I'm not like rushing when it's time to leave. So yeah, let's go. I didn't even say what type of event I'm going to tonight. It's a benefit event, so benefit cosmetics. So yeah.
Oh my gosh, I can literally hear them screaming in the van.
Hello! Hello! Lola, do you need to go pee?
That was like, do you need to go pee? Do you need to go pee? Do you want to go outside? Come on.
You guys, that was the most lackluster reuniting. Come on, let's go pee. Okay, I totally couldn't get my words out there, but like that was not the reaction I was hoping. And I think we often overhumanize dogs and like everyone's like, oh my God, they're gonna be so excited to see you. But like, as you saw, I think the situation being different trumped them seeing me. Anyways, I'm gonna go get this stuff off and then Paul should be home soon and that will be exciting. And I think I'll need to put out that garbage because I just put dog poop in there and it reeks. Oh my gosh, rewind. I probably totally didn't even tell you what happened. I didn't go to that event because I called the courier service that was bringing them and was like, hey, just want to know, like, when are they coming? You said you would call at 4, you haven't called. So I called at 4:45 and they're like, oh, they're almost there. They'll be there by 6, like, latest. Anyways. So I was supposed to be at an event at 6, well, 6:15 came, and then I called them, and I was like, look, you guys said, like, 6:15, the latest, no sign of them, and then they were like, 15 minutes, max. Another 45 minutes later, they got here, so I obviously didn't go to that event. It's okay, I just hate that I got ready. So annoying, but they're here now. We're sleeping. I think they're a little jet lagged and I'm just putting away laundry. So yeah, I don't know if I'm gonna do any vlogging tomorrow. I might. I know for sure I will on Saturday, but yeah. Yay!
Go get him!
He's like, nope, that's enough.
Go get him, Charlie. Go get him!
Once he cuddles with you a couple times, he'll be like,
okay. Oh, you've knocked
him
back twice.
Yeah. Good morning. So I'm on my way to Cabot Circus. Yeah, struggling a bit. Because I'm gonna go get a facial, a rodeo facial. So a couple of weeks ago, I feel like you guys would have seen on the vlog, me and Marilyn went to Joe Malone to see if we could get the like hand and arm massage thing, and we couldn't. But we ran into this other lady there, and she works at the rodeo counter. And she messaged me on Instagram this week asking if I wanted to come in for a facial. So that's what I'm doing this morning. Then I need to pick up a few things to shoot with. And I'm supposed to meet Marilyn and this girl Susanna for lunch, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to make it because Paul and I are headed to Bath this afternoon. So I need to come home, get ready. And we'd like to do some outfit pictures and stuff there before we go to the event. So realistically, when I get home, I should just get ready and then head to Bath. So yeah, that's what's going on today. Anyways, hopefully I didn't miss the bus. Okay, so I just got to the room where they're gonna be doing the facial, and oh my gosh, how nice is it in here? I might be having a mimosa. I don't know, I'm mad about it. But yeah, I'm so stoked.
Dead skin's forming off. So as I keep rubbing, it's just falling off. All down your neck. If you turn your head to the side, it's all down there.
Wow.
So you'll have no dry skin on you now.
Yay!
look at who I found.
So, as you guys saw, I got my makeup done, which wasn't supposed to be a part of the facial, but it was so nice. And we all know that I don't wear this much makeup, so it's actually such a treat to look like this.
I think it suits you very well.
You think so?
Yeah.
Oh,
it's very
thanks.
Nice.
Well, I was supposed to meet up with Marilyn today, and then we were going, where were we gonna go? Bath. Bath, which we're going, Paul and I are going to Bath later, but you've got your
family dinner,
so she can't come. But we're going to meet up with a girl named Susanna. She's from New York. It's like North Americans unite. quickly at the florist, and then I probably won't be able to stay for food, but I'll get a drink. As you saw, I already had a mimosa, and then you guys are doing outfit pictures?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, outfit. Yeah, sweet. Cool. Well, been nice chatting. I'll show you in the florist because have you been there yet?
Never.
I haven't been there yet. I feel like every blogger goes there.
Exactly.
But that's actually why I've stayed away from it, because I feel like when every other person goes somewhere,
you don't feel like it's special?
Well, I just feel like everybody's taking a picture there. How is mine gonna stand out?
Oh yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
I know.
But I think it'll be cute to get like girl brunch pictures there and stuff and hang out. So as we can hear, I sound like a man because I'm really sick.
Everyone's sick.
It's crazy. Yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna have Leilani, who did my makeup and my facial, I'm gonna have her details in the description box down below, so you can check her out if you are in Bristol or surrounding areas.
Alright, let's get where we're at.
Susanna, you've never made it to the vlog before. Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Susie. I'm from New York. I'm a health and fitness coach and a blogger.
And lovely. I'm finding all the North Americans.
Yes.
But we finally made it to the florist. Everybody's come here and now it's our time. Susie's already been here before. This is our first time. My nose is running, so I gotta stop this. I'll show you what we get. Like I'm dressed for winter. Stop ever focusing on me. There we are. My highly conversational date. Wow, we're headed to Bath for an outdoor screening of Grease.
Hence Paul's outfit.
Take a trip into my garden. I've got so much to show ya. The fountains and the waters, begging just to know ya. And it's true, baby, I've been saving this.
So we're just sitting. The vent area's over there, but we can see that.
I feel like we should have turned up to this place with these like flashy motors that they got in Greece.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah.
And then you'd have been like trying to make out with me and stuff, and that's how it goes down.
I feel like they should have invited a lot more people.
The whole place is no parking zone for the face.
You know what? We should probably go over there and make sure that this is the right place, or I should check my phone.
What?
This is the right place.
It's an outdoor cinema in Bath. So, I mean, that's really good.
Do you see a screen?
Outdoor. What do you think that giant thing is there?
But where is everybody?
You want to be the only two.
Just for me. Yeah, I know. Just for you. I know. Just for you. Come on, baby, play me like a love song. Every time it comes on, I get this sweet desire. Yeah, I know. Just for you.
crepes, but
I finished mine. You're almost done yours.
Making a mess of that.
The sky is really pretty over there. Cameras are really picking it up, but and it's really cold. All right, I am back at home, and let's talk about my face. I do think it looks like it's like glowing. So it was so cold at that movie place. My lashes look black. Yeah, it was so cold, so I came home and took a bath. I'm not even a bath person, but like that was necessary. So I think I still have a little bit of makeup on in the inner corner of my eye. But I just came on here to say goodnight, but also to just show you what's in here because Leilani gave me a gift bag. So let's see what's in here. All right, so it's just this Harvey Nichols bag. So it was also the 10th anniversary of Harvey Nichols today. Wow, she put a lot in here. Oh my gosh. All right, so wow. Okay, let's put that there. She gave me a Dragon Blood lip mask. It's moisture rich plumping biocellulose. I might put that on tonight because my lips are so dry. So that's just 15 minutes and then peel away. So and then there is a vitamin C energizing face mask. I think she used this on me today. I think. No, she used the bubble mask. That's what she used on me today. Then there's a pink diamond lifting face mask. And then that's supposed to lift and illuminate. And then there's another vitamin C. Or no, I talked about this one already. So yeah, so there's four of those. And then there's a pink diamond instant lifting serum. So I don't even know what this is. I'm gonna have to look it up on YouTube. And then there's this. I don't know if this is a full size or what, but she hooked me up. Anyways, the Dragon's Blood Sculpting Gel. I believe she used this on me today. And it's supposed to like make everything look plumper and fuller. And then this is the Rose Gold Serum, anti-gravity serum with instant hydrating and lifting radiance. So there's that. And then there's the Bee Venom Super Serum. And that's extreme performance with serum and melanin, peptide stem cellulose biomimetic growth factors. I'm pretty sure she used this on me today, and that's one of the things that has helped my skin now not be as dry. I think it was this and then the glycolic acid that she put on, and like literally it like took off all my dead skin, so that was really cool. And then I think these are just like one use of like these jars. And this is the Hyaluronic Night Cream. That's a vitamin C mask. The Bee Venom Moisturizer. Bee Venom Moisturizer. And then the cleanser. That's the first thing that she put on me today. So yeah, thought I would show you guys. The bed is a mess. I need to clean it up and then set the things aside that I'm going to be shooting with tomorrow. So yeah. Anyways, see you tomorrow. All right, guys, I am back at the salon this morning. I think I showed you a couple of clips there. One of my hair was up, but if you didn't know, I wear extensions most of the time, and my hair is so fine. I don't mind short hair, but I just hate how thin it is. Anyways, so basically what we've got planned for the day is we are going to trim it up, just keep it blunt, just to kind of make it look as full as possible. And then we're just going to be freshening up this brown, kind of give it some shine. And then at the ends, it's faded quite a bit. I've dyed it 3 times darker now. But basically, when you have blonde in your hair, you can't just dye over it and think that the blonde bits underneath are not going to show through. They are going to show through the more that you wash it. So even though I have dyed it dark, I do still need to refresh that. So the last time I did that was like end of August before I went to a wedding. So yeah, I'm so excited to get it freshened up again. And then I think I'm going to do like shorter bangs this time around. So yeah, we'll see. I'm probably going to come to regret that because it is so humid here and my hair is curly, but it's hair. It'll go by.
Traveling these wide roads for so long, my heart's been far from you 10,000. Oh, I wanna come near and give you every part of me. But there's blood on my hands and my lips are unclear. In my darkness I remember Mama's words reoccur to me. Surrender to the good Lord and He'll wipe your slate clean. To your river, I wanna go.
Oh. All right, guys, how's it going? It's been a day. Got the dogs groomed this morning and then did a little bit of cleaning in the house, took a couple pictures because they look so cute. And now I've just got to Saks. Basically, I think they do like all type of aesthetic treatments here. I don't think they do hair or anything, but they invited me to come in for a pedicure and my toes are terrible. I haven't got them done. Usually I get them done like every 6 weeks. It's been 2 months, so
terrible.
Terrible. Anyways, I thought I would bring you guys along and show you what I got done.